Hello everyone, welcome to In 5 Minutes. In this video, we are going to study the FIR filter design using CASA window. By using CASA window, it is possible to obtain separate control upon the length or the order of the filter, and also we can change the transition width of the main lobe. So first we will see the magnitude specifications. The magnitude specifications consist of pass band, transition band and stop band. We can also see the passband ripples and stopband ripples. But first, let us define some terms. Here, delta P is equal to peak passband deviation. Delta S, that is this point, is stopband deviation. As we know that omega P, passband edge frequency, and omega S is equal to stopband edge frequency. Here, there is a term that is delta F. Delta F, as it states, is the transition bandwidth, that is given as delta F is equal to omega S, that is the stopband edge frequency minus the passband edge frequency divided by 2 pi. In CASA window, there are two main parameters, that is the shape parameter, which is given as beta, and another is obviously the length of the window, that is n plus 1. Now the CASA window function is defined as omega n is equal to I0 of beta 1 minus n minus alpha upon alpha the whole square, and this all is raised to half, the whole divided by I0 of beta. This is valid only when n ranges from 0 to capital N, otherwise its function is 0. Here alpha is equal to n by 2, and I0 is the zeroth order modified Bessel function of first kind. Now we will define this function. I0 of x is given as 1 plus 0.25 x square upon 1 factorial the whole square plus 0.25 x square again the whole square 2 factorial the whole square, and it goes on. Now let us see the design steps of CASA window. First, we will choose the optimum value of ripple, that is delta, that is minimum of delta P and delta S. Here, delta S is given by the relation equal to 10 raised to minus 0.05 into AS. Or we can solve DP, that is delta P, which can be found out by AP, is equal to 20 log of 1 plus delta P upon 1 minus delta P to the base 10. If we don't want to use log, then we can directly find out delta P is equal to 10 raised to 0.05 AP minus 1 upon 10 raised to 0.05 AP plus 1. And again, there is another formula for delta S, as if we use log, then AS is equal to minus 20 log of delta S to the base 10. This is the first step. The second step would be calculation of attenuation in decibels. Now, the formula is A is equal to minus 20 log of delta to the base 10. The third step is to calculate the parameter beta from the equations proposed by CASA. Now, these equations are valid if we found A first, and these are dependent on the range of A. Let us see that. Beta have three ranges, that is dependent on three ranges of A. The first range is when A is greater than 50. Here then beta is equal to 0.1102 A minus 8.7. When A lies between 21 and 50, the value is 0.5842 A minus 21 0.4 plus 0.07886 A minus 21. And finally, when A is less than 21, beta is 0. And the fourth step is to calculate the value of N. Now, there is a relation. N is equal to A minus 8, 2.285 delta omega. Now, delta omega is the transition width, which is given by omega S minus omega P. After these steps, we have to choose which type of filter we have to design. It can be low pass or high pass. and calculating the FIR filter coefficients using the equation H of n is equal to HD of n into W of n. So these are the design steps of CASA window. Thank you.